As I walked out one old lady, dark walking day, I spied a thin young woman. She was tightly laced in gray. I removed my hat, straightened my back and to her eyes and say, pray tell to me, pray tell it plainly, but who exactly are you? She hung down her head, she raised up her eyes, this thin young girl with the wizened garment said to my surprise, I'm only here to pass the time until my fancy dies. Pray tell me, sir, are you the kind who would mistreat me? Or are you only coming in across the fields to greet me? Oh no, I said, I'm here to stay, but I may leave next week. I know you are a seagull girl, I can tell it by your beak. I'm worse than that, there are things that I still see. What's that, she said, from behind her veil, this bright and damning lady, who looked not unlike a greyback girl. Search, said I, both night and day, for those who talk my talk, in some far place not too far removed, where I can gladly walk and sing my song, though my heart be mostly chalk. At this she cried through up her arms, and suddenly she grew wings, not unlike those you might find upon a grayback gull. It's over now, she's far and gone, leaving me with my load. The hedges grow, the gardens work, and the garden's not been mowed. I sit and think, I play at cards, and I wonder why she goed. Or did she fly, or was it I, to whom this thing was showed? And the sands are bare, no seagulls, and I think I should have known. She did not say it to my face, but now I can see my luck. Now I know that where my place is, there I can be much. She did not say it to my face, but now I see my love. Now I know that where my place is, there I can be not. She did not say it to my face, now I see my love. Now I know that where my place is, there I can be not.
When dark clouds fall in the skies, I've cast my eyes to the path where we are treading. Oh, I could rack my brains trying to explain where it is I think we are heading.
Tim said to us, I'm not going to sing La La La. So,
and actually said, I'm not going to sing it.
We're going to do a song that came from my second album, very inappropriately named Lily Petty, and it's called Ballad of the Wasp. It's a cautionary tale, an anti-drug song, of course. It's about three people who turned into wasps.
We're very, very opposed to drug taking.
Yes.
And, the head of the drug squad in Ireland at the time, the one Billy Mullins, was very appreciative of that fact.
He was a lovely man, actually.
Gary Moore was doing an interview on the radio, and he was on the end of the telephone, and the guy asked him about heavy petting, and Gary slapped. No,
Gary was being interviewed, and someone rang up at the radio station and said, would you ask Gary Moore about the heavy petting sessions?
Yeah.
And they slammed the phone down.
Old man and a girl of iron laid down to take some.
Street Bridge, a show he never had again. And in the long dark nights in winter, we made music round the fire, chasing our dreams and learning to share.
Takes a little while to sink in.
But that was one of the three new tracks we put on that time. We did Lunar Rock and Sound and The Invisible Kid and Halcyon Days. They were all freshly recorded for that session.
This is Love's Just a Horse. It's about love and it's about a horse. And it was recorded live in the John Peel session with, what was it? Who were we playing with that? James Taylor, he was there. And his girlfriend at the time, Joni Mitchell. And I had this song up on the piano, and it's a complete mistake song. It doesn't make sense at all. But anyway, Joni came over and she was looking at it. Oh, did you write those lyrics? I said, oh, that's so beautiful. And I sort of, anyway, later on, she has heard to be singing. Reading the lyrics and singing it to her own chorus.
And we were kind of delighted to get the chance perhaps to say hello to Johnny Mitchell. And James came out of the dressing room and said, Johnny, where are you? I've never been able to listen to his music since.
James had a terrible grudge against strange James Taylor.
Thank you.
a friend too.
In Dublin recently, we had a string section which was a kind of string duo. Tonight we're reduced to one string player, which is Mr. Goulding.
Probably the next time we won't even have.
The next time there'll be no string players, and the time
no
after that.
Attached, yeah.
The time after that, it'll just be live.
After
that. Recorded this originally, we had an instrument called a one-string fiddle, which Goulding was able to make a very good attempt at a string quartet.
deep and deep and blue. The lamp lights with the pale green glow, the trees of the avenue. The old piano plays an air, sedate and slow and gay. She bends upon the yellow keys, and her head inclines this way. Shy thoughts and grave wide eyes, and hands that wander as they list. Twilight turns to darker gloom, with lights all about it.
Signing the book in Dublin, and I said, who shall I make it out to? And he said, well, James Joyce. I said, really? And the producer's idea, and he was James Joyce.
He had specs, didn't he?
Yeah, and he had a kind of lean, hungry look. After that, we take a little break. He wrote up about a year ago, Frank and Jesse James. At that time, we didn't realize the meaning of the names. He left here a beardless boy, and he's a wanted man, running with the James gang, running with the James gang. Running. Cold winds blow this morning, it looks like it's coming on to rain. He's down in the barrel with Frank and Jesse again. Cards are stacked against him as he deals up another hand. Running with the James gang, running with the James gang. He's running. He's an outlaw now, won't see his face again. Unless it's from another posters they put up for wanted men. Yippee-ya-ya-ya-ka-yay-yay. Yippee-ya-ta-ya-ta-yay. Yippee-ya-ta-ya-ka-yay-yay. Yippee. Seems so dangerous,
Now you're running from the law, you just can't take a stand. Running with the James Gang, running with the James Gang. Frank, could you see me coming? Dreams, they call you by your name, and you have to answer them. You're a moth before the flame, and you can feel the pistol belts of leather in your hand. Running with the James Gang, running with the James Gang. Are no heroes today, it's just a celebrity game. Andy Warhol had it right, to get 15 minutes of fame. Yippee-ya-ta-ya-ta-yay-yay.
Fantastic 4,000 seater,
yeah.
Which
the biggest theater in Europe.
The powers that be pulled down.
Yeah.
Anyway, here we go. I asked Roy Rogers if he'd lend me his horse, and he said, well, yes, of course. And galloping heroically over the plain, you know, I was never seen again. Galloping heroically over the plain, you know, I was never seen again. Bathsheba, did she take off her clothes?
you tell me exactly what the game is? I asked Lloyd George if he'd lend me his hat, and he said, put his arms around my shoulders and taught me how to sing a little deep. He taught me everything. His arms around my shoulders and taught me how to sing a little deep. A little deep. He taught me everything. Rising the Stone, I was very broke. And in Dublin parlance, that's borassic. I hadn't a penny to my name. But I had a bank statement lying beside the desk and an overdraft. And I wrote the lyrics on it. I wrote this song on the bank overdraft. Noble piece of craft. Oh, it's in the burning shaft. And the sub-manager says that I sell lots of bread. Hey, that's no way to treat your friend. The sub-manager says that I sell lots of bread. Hey, that's no way to treat your friend.
Each other, and this is what
we did say. Hand me down my hints and traces, harness up my trusty mare. I have the notion to go to the places, for to see my true love there. Hand me down. Well, I gambled all our money way down in an endless diamond. Now there's some peace in the soul valley. I'm coming back, and I'll gamble one more time. So hand me down my heads and traces,
harness up my trusty mare. I've the notion to go to the races, for to see my true love there. Said, hand me down my names and traces, harness up my trusty mare. I've the notion to go to the races, for to see my true love there.
Hand me down,
England and Scotland, called Humphrey Whiteman. Humphrey was an original member of Scousers for one or two gigs. He's a pretty nifty guitar player. He now plays in a band called something like the Alternative Weather Systems.
Foul weather
Gale Work or something. Humphrey is very elusive, and he might just appear out of the blue, or suddenly you get a phone call in the middle of the night and he's driving across the desert in Arizona selling Ovation guitars to the Indians. He's a strange guy.
Nash Rand, he was selling Nash cars one time. Nash Rand.
So I refer to him as the Invisible King. 1, 2, 3, 4. Came by today. At least I think he did. And I'd like to say he was looking well. With a kid like that, it's really hard to tell. Took off his hat, pulled up a chair. I could clearly see he was hardly there. Just a shadow boy on the edge of the night. Tricked out of the light. He dusted his boots, hitched up his pants, said, I've just come in from Paris, France.
they're eating snails there. It's a heck of a thing. How you been?
And I said, I'm fine, love.
How about you? He said, what am I supposed to do? They see right through me everywhere I go. Don't you know? The invisible kid, you can see him too. And he wants to know what you're gonna do when the chips are down and the die's cast and the future rolls into the past.
Next song is self-explanatory, and I don't know what that means.
They're all self-explanatory.
Is this crowd self-explanatory?
Hello?
All these people? So
yeah, they explain themselves afterwards.
I'm up on Howth Hill, I can see the lights of Dublin over there. On the sacred hill of Howth, the ghosts tonight are burning up the air. I'm up on Howth Hill and I'm paying my respects to you, Phil. A lot of water under bridges, but I got an image of you still. The river flows, taking all our memories to the sea. And Olivia knows it's time to let that old black eagle be. Up on Howth Hill and I'm paying my respects to you, Phil. A lot of water under bridges, but I got that old prodigious thrill. Dragons in the air tonight, behind the moon I hear their bitter wings. There is no need to lie. Tonight the time has come to face the faceless things. Shadows falling all around Howth's lonely promontory of land. I recall the way back then we thought we were so outstanding. Should've talked to me about the burden of the load you took up on the road to fame.
lifting waters kiss the damaged toes of broken rocks below the hill.
Thank you. Quite a good album, to be honest with you. this is one, actually, it'd be best if Tim talked about it more than I.
Well, it was written in 1970, and we played it with Strangely. So I remember we played it in Newcastle, with Fotheringay, in fact. And it's really written about looking out of the window of my schoolhouse, where I've been for 50 years in Southwest Ireland. And every year there's a tragedy at sea, ever since I've been there, so fishermen deserve every penny there. But I used to look out the window and see the herring fleets in the bay. And this is really a song for fishermen, to celebrate them, and to celebrate the mountains, and to celebrate ourselves.
We've got a choir.
Oh yes, we have a choir.
Yes.
Choir. Matured out of choir. Where are they?
Choir!
Choir. Some bits of choir. We have couple of guest singers.
Who are the choir two?
We have Rose Simpson. Sound.
Yeah.
And we thought, oh, why didn't we think of something?
Nothing.
Play the call out from the deep at the end of a rusty tether. They that wheel both to and fro, staggering about like drunken men. They that call out from the deep at the end of a rusty tether.
The other day, actually, our collective age, not allowing for our rhythm section, is nearly 400 years. So if we add in the audience, I think we're right back at Hadrian's Wall.
We'll be right back.
songs. But we have a little talk for you.
Yes.
And as it's Sunday, this is very, very appropriate, I think.
And the lyrics are by W.H. Davis, who wrote The Diary of a Supertramp. Autobiography.
It was a Prince Renzi at the time.
The upkeep tonight.